Hey, Brits, welcome back to XCom Enemy Unknown. Well, first things first, new kernel means new name. So, I'm drawing from Harvey Birdman Attorney at Law for this one, namely the video game. And in that game, there's actually a chance where you get a fake ID, and the fake ID name is Nobuyuki Johnson. And the fake picture is a picture of Ryu from Street Fighter. So, yes. Nobuyuki Stiff Johnson, because dick jokes. Me and dick jokes, that we get along too well. So we stepped in it pretty good last time because a new friend decided to show up. Contact detected. An unidentified UFO. Well, this guy actually is the abductor that I failed to take out in a previous. Was it 1 or 2 months ago? I think it was 2 months ago. Where I had a chance to take it out, but my interceptor was basically one hit away from being blown up, so I made the business decision to hold off. I probably needed one more hit to get rid of this guy, but it didn't happen. Anyway, we have to take care of this now. Now, I think I'm all set. Yep, I'm 90% sure I'm all set. Let's go. So now, there's going to be a lot of aliens here. A lot of them. So this is going to be by no means easy. Avis landings usually end up being pretty scary with the amount of aliens they can throw at you. This right here is going to be the worst one yet. Because this is considered a large... I think maybe the third largest type of alien ship in the game. So there's going to be quite a handful of enemies here. Strike 1, you are green to deploy. Approach with extreme caution. Current enemy status at the site is unknown. Also, a lot of dead horses here because apparently aliens like beating dead horses. Always whenever you face an abductor, we see these, and usually they'll be earmarked by these little pods right here. That's usually a good indicator of what you're doing. So anyway, let's be very careful how we do this. There's probably somewhere around 20 aliens here, and you can get jumped like 6 at a time if you're not careful. So yeah, be very, 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 very careful.
Yes, Commander.
And don't forget, your snipers know how to take high cover and low cover. So I expect to see everything here. Mutons. Muton Berserkers. Usually it might be the first time you actually see a Muton Berserker is here. You know, if you didn't take down the abductor previously.
Heading to that location.
So. Surprise, surprise.
Roger. I've got my eyes.
So I expect to see the full complement here.
Will do.
And maybe beyond the full complement. So, I'm showing this one the whole way through, kind of look at the base, but I'll cut forward to anything that actually happens.
On Overwatch.
I think it's jumped by 6 aliens right now, for all I know. Or get introduced to some new aliens. That also is a distinct possibility. So, anyway, there is a giant centerpiece right here, and there's always aliens here. Always. You can also see aliens sometimes in the wings over here, but it's kind of, it doesn't always work that way.
Headed there now. I'm rolling.
I might be better served to actually throw a scanner out right now. Let's see what we got. Floaters or thin men? I can't tell. Or maybe that's a cyber disk. What do we got? A thin man. Well, why not? These guys cheat. So I can cheat too. The magically appearing mutons, everybody! And I see that 20 right there in the background. That's gotta be more mutons. So, I'm gonna get crowded. This is not good. Good shot, Sanchez. That's not perfect. I demand perfection from you. And satisfaction. Wait, what? I'm a little unnerved to see that 20 piece that was over there. That unnerves me. That's two mutons and a berserker, by the way. I guarantee you that much. Yeah, try it. Now, of course, I didn't use double tap last time, so even though it said double tap, the truth was, nope. Great.
Heading to that location.
I'm not sure where those thin men went at all. Real kids, if they could be anywhere right now. And you know how thin men like to outfox people.
Got him.
Good thing I didn't take cover by that behind that pod. That would have been upsetting. This is kind of why scope is sometimes a good idea here. Because, as you see, even with high cover, I still have a 71% chance to land my shot. Look at that. Look at that.
X-ray neutralized.
Sometimes that 10 really does make a difference. Other times, it makes you want to pull your hair out.
Moving.
Because you know I missed 91s and 96s already.
I feel, Commander. Roger that. Overwatch. Aye, aye.
I don't like using the pods for cover, but truth is, there isn't any other options, so... As soon as you start getting to the ship itself, you should be in better shape. Oh look, there's one now. He's dead. There's no way he's surviving that.
X-ray neutralized.
What was that?
There's the other one. Interesting. So they're just running into position to get themselves kicked? And I saw that. I saw that.
Open fire.
Where do you guys teleport in from? And I hear cyber discs on the other end. Cruelty, thy name is XCom. I mentioned I could jump, but this is looking that way right now. God damn it. God damn it. Oh, I hate this game. I really hate this game sometimes. Okay. No. Doesn't beat around the bush here. Alright. goes without saying, I really don't care for this guy nearly as much, ironically, even though I know they cheat like hell. Hmm. 91% chance to nail that Mouton. But I think it goes without saying the Berserker is the way worse option. So, let's get him pissed off at me. Yeah, that's right. Roar! Please note that when they run after you, hit them, they will not actually attack. So even though it looks like they're actually running in a hissy fit trying to kill you, they're not. Something interesting to note. I don't know why my version does that, where it kind of like gets all laggy and shit. Okay, Cyberdisc is definitely one of the things I want to get out of the way for sure. I'm not even gonna pretend. Cyberdisc over there. Might be better to actually go over here and take cover. As bad as it seems, I don't think these guys can actually reach me from over there. Matter of fact, I can't even see them, which is kind of insane to think about, but hey. You take what you get.
Responsible for the attacks taking place during the alien abductions?
Always disappointing me, Daniels. I forgot about that part. How disappointing. Again. Really? I have no words for this. I have no words for this. Good or bad. I do have a sudden urge to drink. So now what? Now what is the big question here? Truthfully, I think I might just move. I might just move this turn. But the question is, where do you move? I'm amazed Midboss didn't actually panic that turn. Sometimes things are weird. My big fear is one of the Mutons is going to throw a grenade, and when he does, it's going to blow the cover I have. It's not ideal, to say the least.
They're falling back.
He might actually fall back. He did. Kind of was hoping that. Oh look, you blew up his cover. Dang it. Yeah. Watch the grenade. Ow! No grenade, just ouchies. Oh, I see you're finally back on your feet. Thank you. I really need that now. Bitch. Okay. Whatever. This guy now actually is susceptible to crits, so you know what? that's okay, that's okay. I can actually take that. There you go. If he panics again, I'm gonna snap. Ooh! Nice shot! What a lovely shot that was. It's tough because I don't know what I really want to do. A grenade might actually kill that thing, I just can't tell. Getting closer might help though. Unless I'm going to be greeted by my other mortal enemy of bullshit sidelines. You just love to disappoint me, don't you? You're good at that sort of thing, ain't you? Like, damn. Right there. I think this will count as a hit. I hope it'll count as a hit. It counted as a hit. Well, you know, I'll take it. 20% chance, not really my style. I'm kind of in deep doo-doo right now. I really hate to do this. I kind of think maybe my best option is actually use a rocket here. The problem is, I'm afraid of actually getting hit by that Thin Man when he comes back. And he might come back. That's the thing. I don't know. I get close enough. I should be able to pummel him with a grenade. This should be more than enough. Going out. Just another one of those bad breaks, I guess. That panic can really throw you. Okay, it looks like I'm safe. There are two wings here. Obviously, there's a right wing and a left wing. You can go through here as well and end up underneath. Aliens like to hide out in both of these rooms. So even though I want to pursue the Thin Man, it's just not a good idea. Ultimately, all three of these little sections right here end up towards the center room. So, and of course the two wings as well. They all end up towards the center room right behind here. And that could be where a bunch of your firefighting happens too.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Alright. Let's burn one of these things and see what's here. Sure enough.
Tanks of some kind. As repugnant as this
now,
may be,
this is sort of a story-based UFO. Of course, the chances you'd actually take them down are kind of 50-50, but the whole concept is you're supposed to see alien stasis tanks and surgery for the first time here instead of at the base. Of course, I saw it at the base, so yeah, that threw that out of the way. He's actually hiding behind one of those stasis tanks right now.
Heading to that location.
Hey, buddy.
They're backing up. Advance.
Let's be sure. Let's be sure we get him out of here. And I hate to have this backfire horribly. As you see, you have two outdoor wings right there where the power sources are, but then they lead over to right here, and beyond this door is the bridge. That would be where the Sector commanders are going to be hanging out. But this is supposed to be where you first learn what ship is responsible for the abductions, which is implied to be this. It's supposed to be the first time you see alien surgery tables, which you also see in the bridge, and stasis tanks, which you see here. So, yeah, you're supposed to figure out at this point that, yeah, these guys, they mean serious business, and they don't care you survive or not. They are not your friends. Peace, no peace. Just like the movie Independence Day. I'm a little concerned it could be aliens hanging out over here-ish. Likelihood's very low, but hey. Game threw what, like 8 aliens at me at once? So. Okay, yeah, you can actually climb those outer ladders to get on top of the ship. Usually no points in matter, unless Thinman likes to get up there. Aliens know how to climb quite well, so. As for if the enemies are in here, they could either be down here, or they could be up there. So let's cover one of the areas and eliminate the possibility, shall we? Okay, they're in the immediate area. This will make Walker very useless when her running gun triggers. Let's go.
I've seen enough. I don't think there's
three of them
now. The goal of this alien research is the detriment of all mankind.
As I said, I think this really was implied to be done at before the base, but if you don't shoot it down, that doesn't happen. But I would think you see all the alien surgery tables and stuff in the base, that usually would be a pretty good idea that, oh, yeah, these guys are bad news. Anyway, two in the immediate area means they're pretty easy to actually hit. So I'm gonna go for the one that's more difficult and just proceed to barnstorm him and kick his ass. Goodbye.
I'm about to start keeping score.
And it also means flanking becomes very easy. This is a really stupid shot. But can you blame me? Can you blame me at all? I don't think so.
On it.
With that said, however, let's use grenades. I can actually blow up the, maybe I can blow up some of the cover too. That'd be very nice. That did it. I think that did it. That did not do it. Oh well, that's fine.
Heading there now.
Let's go do XCOM things by getting right on the guy's grill, realize you have a 75% chance to stick him, decide, oh, forget it. Grenade! Seriously. Nothing's more XCOM-y than getting right up in the enemy's grill and missing them point-blank range. One tile away and all that. By the way, pistol does come into play here, and look at how... Oh, look how incredible this is. Wow. 111 plus 10 plus 22 minus 20 plus 40, and you still have an 83% chance. And, yeah, I believe double tap actually works here, too. Pretty awesome, ain't it? That just leaves one. Daniels, do not disappoint me here. I know I keep telling you this, but please don't.
Excellent work.
It's only 15 of them, wow. That's a little lower than I thought. But success is success. Got a little hairy there in the beginning, but other than that, survived, and we're getting a lot of alloys for this. And Von Karma's out for 9 days. I'm guessing PTSD is also involved. But I think we did well here. And don't forget, stasis tanks and surgery are indeed vanity. I can build this now, which is great. Once this thing is built, you'll start to actually see the your next story-based mission. 14 days, huh? So it may not be done until the end of the month. Well, still, gotta do it. I would love to get this too, but unfortunately. I'll probably not ever do the skeleton suit. For me, it always ends up being kind of just outclassed by the carapace, and then, well, not really the carapace per se, but it's after the carapace, but at that point you're happy about having the carapace, so you don't really care, and then you get to the next suits of armor, and it's like, it's not even a fair fight. The whole point of the skeleton, though, is it allows you to grapple hook up to the higher heights, rare vantage points and stuff. So, it's got its uses. Should be fine with just that. You know, screw it. Screw it. Ooh! But I can't do anything right now. True. I mean, true, I could pull one up, but unfortunately I can't. I need uplinks. Servo generator, everybody. So there's my 20 extra power, which is huge. Illyrium's done. No real advantage here, but you do get an improved arc thrower, which is very nice, because now the arc thrower, which used to only be effective at 3 HP, now becomes effective at 6 HP. We can't actually make Illyrium, that's fine. But that improved arc thrower is very useful. Especially when you start to get desperate and you need to knock down an alien that has like 5 HP or whatever, then it becomes vital. It also will increase your chances of stunning at 1 or 2 HP. I think 1 through 3 is like 95% chance after this, which is nice. And new armor, Titan armor. The heaviest armor in the game gives you 10 extra HP. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. As I said, this comes out of class very quickly. But either way, the new firecraft's getting our attention. Because we're going to need it, desperately. There's our psionic labs. That's right. We can now go and mindfuck things of our own. So how does the psionic labs work? You take a soldier, and you decide to put him in there for 10 days.
Our current research implies a strong link between a candidate's willpower and their psionic potential.
Now, they'll either be found gifted or not gifted, and it usually depends on their will being higher. Not always, though. Not always. I've seen some pretty low wills actually become gifted, and I've seen some soldiers with very high will not get theirs, so you want it to be those with higher will. And I usually don't want to be my snipers, because they're usually not in range. So someone like a support, or a heavy, would be great. Unfortunately, it looks to me like I'm kind of SOL here. So, in that case, yeah. I really don't like to have more than one or two in there at a time, because you're out without them for 10 days. You know how much that can catch up to you if a terror mission comes up? It's not a good thing. Anyway, I think I'm actually going to have this guy. Don't disappoint me, Daniels! Also, I'm not sure, but I think you might be able to disarm them when they're in this. So, let's do that. So, Daniels, don't disappoint me. Trademark. And I can be without him. It's fine. And we'll see what happens after 10 months. Let's see. Hyperwave relay. Yeah, let's build it right now. Screw it. Get done.
Commander, there's a priority one transmission coming.
What do we have? Oh! Now, is the game gonna screw me here? I don't know. Target escort. A combat engineer unaffiliated with XCom has come under attack while investigating possible alien contamination. Okay, I know what this one is. It'll be a lot of thin men, but I think I can do it. So. That's what I'm gonna do next time. See you guys later. 40 Warriors signing off.